Hello, it's Polish Paul VR, welcome to the channel and let's do review of Party Pumper, a game that lets you become virtual DJ. But is it good or does it suck balls? I'm gonna tell you all about it, so let's just jump into it. And before I start, I want to say this is one of those under $10 games. So I went to it with very low expectations. I didn't like kind of expected a lot from this game, but I'm happy to say it kind of exceeded my expectations. But keep in mind, like I said, it's only a small priced game, so don't expect a lot of content, and that was my main issue with the game. But anyway, let's just start, let's do it properly, let's start from the graphics. So you put in your headset on, you firing up the game, and it looks alright. You've got two venues, maybe three if you count tutorial. It's a nightclub and a like a pool party, and you basically playing for people there. People are nicely rendered, nice, okay models, textures are nice, and when it comes to blurriness, it's not too bad, it's alright, so I can appreciate that. Now when it comes to the gameplay, it's not a proper DJ game when you've got your console and you like mixing stuff around. It's more of a, let's say, time-based DJ putting shapes on the console game. Because you've got consoles, you've got different shapes, they are making a bit different sound, and you have to put them on to the beat, so you can do a sound cue, which you can hear in your ears, or there's a visual cue, little line down, going down, and then you know when to place your shapes on the DJ table. All you have to do is make sure that the vibe of the party is quite good, so you can see it in front of you. When you mess up, it's going down. When party popper comes on stage, they come in as well and annoy people, you have to choke them off or throw something at them, because otherwise of course the vibe will be lower. And also you can do combos, with those combos you can make special effects, so it's quite a lot to this game. And apart from that, another mechanic is you've got little robot friend and he gives you bits and bobs of stuff to play with. You can get tin of spray, which I really like, and paint something in the sky. You've got foam, you can throw it at people, you can create some bubbles, you can light up some firework, you can pull some gravy glasses, he passes you cocktails and drinks and stuff like that. So like I said, even though it's a smaller game, there was a lot of like mechanics, let's say, to it. But also let me address the raving elephant in the room, which is of course the how much content is in it. And like I said, it's not a lot. Thankfully the game supports difficulty modes, so you can start from easy and go to hard. So I'm assuming if you get into this game, you probably could get good like 5-6 hours of gameplay, so for the price it's not too bad. But also keep in mind there's not that much variety once you saw everything. But to see everything, of course, you have to keep getting better, so that's what's gonna keep you going. Song selection, it's this generic EDM maybe music, it's alright, it didn't annoy me, it didn't blow me away, I don't like this type of music anyway, so I kind of cannot judge, but you've got different tracks every time you restart the game, so I appreciated that. When it comes to the tracking, it was okay as well, but sometimes some actions, like you put your moves of course in front of your headset, and the of course PlayStation camera will be like, okay, I don't know which light I'm tracking now, let's get confused and let's blow your move somewhere to the end of times away from you. But it didn't happen a lot, thankfully your console is below you, so you're just placing stuff. But once, you know, sometimes it can happen faster, when you, especially when you play on harder difficulties. So if you lose tracking, it can get annoyed a bit, but not too much. Anyway, all in all, let me just summarize, because there's not that much to say about this game. Apart from, like when I started, it did exceed what I expected. It's kind of quite high quality, even though it's not much to it. I enjoyed it. It's not a game I can give like a perfect score or out, but also it's not the worst game, so I'm gonna give it 6.5 out of 10. I enjoyed it, it was okay, I had few issues here and there, the tutorial was a bit boring, but all in all, when you put all this experience together for the little price you pay, it's one of those feel-good games, so you're gonna just jump into it and it's gonna make you feel good, because it's okay. Once you know, work out everything for yourself, because tutorial I found a bit boring, but mechanics are not too complicated, thankfully. Okay, if you like what you're seeing, then please press a like, because it does helps the channel a lot. And if you're new to the channel and are not subscribed, then subscribe. It's always better when it's more of us. And that's it, bye.